Different groups have built brain probes, integrated brain probes, for some years. Our contribution was to add the chemical sensing to these brain probes that heretofore had measured only the electrical signals. In my view, it's much like adding color to photography. We know that the neurotransmitters are very important in the function of the brain, and it's important to be able to monitor those as well as the firings of the neurons. Our latest research in neural interfaces was done by a student of mine, Spencer Kellis, who placed micro-ECOG electrodes on the surface of human patients' brains and then processed the signals from the local field potentials. He was able to achieve very good recognition of 10 spoken words. The end objective of this would be to help locked-in patients be able to communicate. If they had even a small vocabulary, it would change their quality of life significantly. To be able to say, "I'm hungry," "I'm cold," "I love you," would make a big difference to their lives. I actually had a friend who had Lou Gehrig's disease. We used to go and sit with him, and I know how difficult it is to be locked in. I've thought about him many times as we've done this research and how wonderful it would have been had he been able to communicate with his loved ones during those last months of his life.